Hair. It's so ubiquitous, most of us don't give it a second thought. But as we saw in Hair Magic, from beautician to magician, proper sculpting of human hair can be a deep, complicated endeavor. Our previous discussion focused primarily on North America, but let's take a look at some more examples. The peoples of Africa are as varied as its landscapes. From the cradle of humanity come some of the most colorful cultures on the planet. Sudan may have been the 17th fastest growing economy before South Sudan split off, but the country is still very tribal. This young woman is from the Kuba tribe of the Kuba Mountains. She has her hair styled into tight cornrows or Ghana braids. Not only are these tight, tiny braids attractive, they are functional. She most likely has very tight kinks or curls in her hair, so the tight braids allow her to keep them both orderly and clean. The cornrow braids reappear on this cattle herdsman from Sudan's Umbadoro tribe. He wears his hair built and seemingly stitched into a crest that shows his social status. This young man from Cape Town, South Africa, wears a variant of the Madiba hairstyle made famous by Nelson Mandela. It makes use of his tight, kinky hair, gradients, and fades for a smart look. Here we see it with one shaved line, but two or three lines aren't uncommon. The Madiba style is mostly worn by men, but some young women adopt it as well. This young woman, also from Cape Town, is having cornrows braided into her hair. From the tribal lands to the city streets, you'll find these braids across Africa. With their longevity and ease of care, both women and men love them. From the cradle of humanity to some of the oldest civilizations on Earth, Asia is a land of contrasts. Traditional and modern, exotic and familiar, wild and civilized. One of the oldest civilizations on Earth, the hairstyles of China evoke feelings both familiar and foreign. Many traditional Chinese styles are produced with techniques with which you are already familiar: buns, braids, rolls, and ponytails. Often what makes them stand out is their unique ornamentation. So iconic is this combination of simple technique and decoration that it is used by neighboring countries to denote a character being from China, like shampoo from Rumiko Takahashi's Ranma 1/2. What comes to mind when you think of Japan? Sushi? Snow monkeys? Anime? How about geisha? Women that become geisha dedicate their lives to service. They must master hosting, conversation, storytelling, and dozens of other skills, all while maintaining an ethereal, almost too perfect appearance. Their hair is kept very traditional, being made, like China, of familiar techniques and heavy ornamentation. Sakura blossoms and decorative combs are common. But compare the grace of the geisha to the fashion of Harajuku. This district of Tokyo is known for outrageous clothes, hair, and makeup. It's as if the Harajuku girls are turning away from tradition. Traveling west, we find Europe. In terms of fashion, Europe is very much like North America. It helps that the dominant people of Canada and the USA are of European blood. So instead, let's look at some more traditional styles. Like China and Japan, Greece is one of the oldest countries and is said to be the birthplace of democracy and Western civilization. Greek women were masters of the updo, using rolls and fillers or wrapped braids. Many different varieties of styles proliferated and can still be found today for fashion shows, photo shoots, and special events. Like the Greeks, the Scots work some real magic with braiding. The Greeks often liked to put their hair up, but the Scots women would leave theirs down. Sometimes they'd create an effect reminiscent of waterfalls, or maybe intricate weaving. Even when they'd wrap it up in rolls, the longest lengths would still be left to fall down the back. The Americas are some of the world's youngest cultures, but they draw upon the traditions of their parent nations. What would Brazil be without the Portuguese? Completely different anyway. Speaking of Brazil, South America's largest country has some of its largest hair. Weaves and extensions are totally in vogue in Brazil. Looking for images of Brazilian women, many were modeled with the extensions they intended to put into their hair. The hair is worn very long, and either very kinky or deeply waved. Argentina was the only country where Google showed me men when I searched for hairstyles. It's also the only country where men were depicted with long hair more often than not. Long, flowing waves and layers dominate the men of Argentina, conjuring images of the beach and seas and a relaxed, leisurely lifestyle. It's interesting to see what other peoples do with fashion, from the traditional to modern. Once you've learned the fundamentals of hair magic, you can help anyone from anywhere. Hopefully this short introduction has served to fuel your imagination. Good luck, hair magician.